Hello everyone, welcome to video lecture series of Communication Engineering. Today's topic is Phase Shift Keying, that is PSK. PSK is one of the digital modulation technique. In this video, I'll be talking about how many types of PSKs are there, basically two variants, then BPSK modulator and BPSK demodulator. Let us begin. What do you mean by digital modulation techniques? Digital modulation, it uses discrete signal for modulating a carrier wave. Digital modulation removes communication noise as well as it provides enhanced strength for the signal. And digital modulation is always preferred over the analog modulation techniques. There are various advantages, like it gives more capacity of data, high information security, accessibility at a faster rate. So these are various advantages of the digital communication. And because of numerous advantages of digital communication, they are in a huge demand. They are used by a number of users. They are used in number of applications as well. And because of their capacity for communicating superior quality of information in comparison to the analog modulation technique. So these are the various advantages because of which they are always preferred one. There are many types of digital modulation techniques and some of their combinations also exist. So depending upon the requirement of the combination, the modulation techniques can be utilized into a number of applications. But three basic techniques are there, prominent techniques you can say. ASK, that is amplitude shift keying, FSK, that is frequency shift keying, and PSK or phase shift keying. So in this video, I'll be talking about the phase shift keying. What do you mean by phase shift keying or PSK? How can you define it? PSK is a digital modulation technique and it conveys data by changing, that is modulating, the phase of a constant frequency reference signal. This constant frequency reference signal is nothing but the carrier wave, and this modulation is achieved by, or modulation is accomplished by, varying the sine and cosine inputs at a particular time. So this is how this type of modulation is being achieved. Or you can define PSK is a digital modulation technique in which phase of carrier signal is changed by varying sine and cosine inputs at a particular time. PSK technique, that is widely used in a number of applications like wireless LAN, biometric, contactless operations, along with RFID, Bluetooth communication, satellite communication. So there are various applications. And in case of phase shift keying, the phase of output signal gets shifted depending upon the input. So if MTD is equal to 1, means if the baseband signal is 1, then the carrier signal will be within phase. And if it is 0, then the carrier signal will be out of phase, which will be transmitted actually. According to the number of phase shift, there are mainly two types of PSK. First is binary phase shift keying technique, that is BPSK, and second is the quadrature phase shift keying, that is QPSK. So this is the classification which depends on the number of phase shift. So now let us talk one by one in brief, and then I'll be talking about the BPSK in this particular video. First, what is binary phase shift keying? Binary phase shift keying, this is also known as a two-phase PSK or phase reversal keying. So in this technique, sine wave carries two phase reversals like 0 degree and 180 degree. That is why it is known as a binary two-phase PSK. And BPSK is basically a double sideband suppressed carrier DSB-SC modulation, which you have already studied. So this is a double sideband suppressed carrier modulation scheme for a message being the digital information. So here the information, which is the message signal, that is in the digital form. Second is the quadrature phase shift keying. Quad means 4. So this is the phase shift keying technique in which the sine wave carrier that takes 4 phase reversals, and 4 phase reversals are 0 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree and 270 degree. So in this particular kind of technique, this particular technique which we are saying a quadrature phase shift keying, that can be extended further. So PSK can be done or can be accomplished by using 8, 16 values accordingly, depending upon the requirement. So this particular kind of technique, it can be extended further as well. So now let us talk about in detail for binary phase shift keying. So first, you know what is binary phase shift keying or BPSK, that is also known as a two-phase PSK or phase reversal keying. So now let us understand how the generation means modulation and demodulation is being done. So first, this is the block diagram of a BPSK modulator. BPSK is binary phase shift keying technique. So in this diagram, you can observe that it consists of a balance modulator. There is a carrier sine wave, carrier wave generator and the message signal, like and message signal, that is the binary sequence. If we say carrier, that is represented by CT, that is what? If this is cos omega CT and the message signal is MT, so message signal will be what? It may be 1, 0, something certain combination particularly. So at the output, you will be getting the BPSK signal, means binary phase shift keying signal. So what you can write over here, ST is equal to what? Plus minus MT depending upon the sine into cos omega CT. So this is what you are getting, the PSK wave at the output. So here you must remember that the modulation of BPSK, that is done by using a balance modulator, and the function of the balance modulator is to multiply the inputs which is being applied over here. And what is the input which is being applied? One is the carrier wave generator, carrier wave signal, and second is the message signal, the binary signal. So at the output, you are getting the product of these two. So for a zero binary input, the phase will be 0 degree, and for high input, the phase reversal will be 180 degree. Right, so this is how you can understand it, and you can now say how simple this is. This technique is very simple, and accordingly you can draw the BPSK modulated waveform as well. You must be having certain input binary sequence, and accordingly you can plot the BPSK modulated output. So this is what the input binary sequence is being given over here. On the x-axis, time is being taken, and input binary sequence, that is a combination of 10 something, and here you can observe in the binary phase shift keying modulated waveform how the phase is being changed. So the output sine wave of the modulator, that will be direct input of the carrier or the inverted, means 180 degree phase shifted input carrier, which is a function of the data signal. So this is how you can explain the BPSK modulator. Now let us talk about the BPSK demodulator, how the original signal is recovered back from the BPSK signal. So here you can observe the input of the input is the BPSK signal, and from this signal the message signal is to be reconstructed, or means required one, which is being received. So the overall this demodulator, you can understand it by dividing it into two stage. This is the first stage and this is the second stage. So overall function you can understand like in this particular manner. And if you observe this particular block diagram of BPSK demodulator, you can see there is a use of mixer, local oscillator, bandpass filter and a detector. Detector is the two input detector. You can observe over here the inputs to the detector are two. One is the output of the bandpass filter and second is the bit clock, and the output of detector is the original signal, which is the required one. So by recovering the band limited message signal, here band limited signal is required to be recovered from the input stage, and that is done by using this mixer circuit and the bandpass filter. So first stage of demodulation is completed at this particular point. So the baseband signal, which is band limited, that is obtained, and this signal is used to regenerate the binary message bit stream. Means with the help of this particular signal, binary message bit stream is to be regenerated. Now let us observe about the second stage. So in the next stage of demodulation, in the second stage, here bit clock is already applied. So bit clock rate is required at the detector circuit to produce original binary message signal, means at the same rate. If the bit, this particular bit clock, if the bit rate is a sub multiple of the carrier frequency, then bit clock regeneration is simplified. So this is a required condition, this is a necessary condition, that bit rate must be sub multiple of the carrier frequency, right? And to make this circuit overall to easily understand, there may be a use of decision making circuit, that may also be inserted at the second stage of the detection. So what is the function of the decision making circuit? So whatever the output is being like achieved, that is to be compared with the threshold. If that is crossing the threshold level, means that will be identified at the signal as a 1, otherwise that will be treated as a 0. So this is how you can explain this particular block diagram, right? Now what is to be done over here? If you have to derive the mathematical equation, how we are getting at the output and how to represent it. See, if we say we are getting YT, which is the product of this and this, ST is the BPSK signal, and the carrier signal, if carrier signal is represented by a CT, and what is CT? That is nothing but cos omega CT. So what you are getting at the output? YT, that is equal to what? ST into cos omega CT. ST already you know, that is nothing but this is M into T into cos omega CT and into cos omega CT. So this particular term will be the square. If you simplify it further, you will be getting this is nothing but MT, and this term will be what? 1 plus cos 2 omega CT upon 2. If you expand this particular equation, what you are getting? The first term will be plus minus MT upon 2, and the second term will be plus minus MT into cos 2 omega CT upon 2. So here you can observe, when it is being passed from the bypass filter and the detector, then at the output, what you will be getting? The first component, this particular plus minus MT upon 2, right? This term. At the output, you will be getting this term only, which is nothing but the data, or you can say this is the required information which is to be extracted over here. So this is how you can represent, how you can extract the original information. The function of BPSK demodulator is listed out over here. I have already explained. Now let us talk about the advantages and disadvantages of PSK. There are various advantages, and some of them are: phase shifting technique, it allows information to be transmitted in a radio communication in a more efficient way. The way of transmitting the information, that is very, very efficient in comparison to the FSK. It is less prone to error. High rate of data transmission is achieved over here, and it is also more power efficient in comparison to the other techniques. If you compare it with the other demodulation techniques, so it is also more power efficient. And by using this, high transmission data rates can be achieved with the help of high level PSK modulation like QPSK, 16QAM, and so many other variants are also there. There are certain disadvantages also. It has very less bandwidth as compared to ASK, and it is a type of non-coherent reference signal. It is extremely difficult algorithm which is used to decode the binary information which is transmitted during the phase shifting technique. Sometimes PSK, they are extremely sensitive for the phase differences, and it can sometimes generate wrong modulation also. So these are the various limitations or the drawbacks of the PSK. Thank you so much for watching this video.